Cause I'm searching for that special place. Welcome back to another FOOLCRAFT, my fellow friends. I hope you guys are having a fantastic day today. I'm having a great day. Today is my birthday. That's right, a fool for FOOLCRAFT. wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. I'm probably having a very relaxing day, I think. This is the day before, so I don't know. I'm assuming it's a wonderful day. I'm sure it is. Anyways, I just want to start off by saying thank you so much for all the amazing support on this series. You guys have shared so many amazing tips and tricks and left tons of comments and likes, and I super, super appreciate it. It means the world to me, especially on my birthday. So yeah, thanks to you guys for making this series absolutely wonderful. So yeah, where are we? Well, you might have guessed we're in a rather large pit. That's right, and I'm doing some ore mining and stuff is getting cleaned out, but let's go all the way to the top here and let's take a look at where we're at. So in the last episode, we did a little bit of exploring and we found this really cool ice biome. I think it's Ice Plains is the official one. And so we set up shop over here. And what I've done in the last day is I've gone ahead and dug down using vein miner and just grinding it out, to be perfectly honest. I had to do a lot. I basically dug a box and then I vein mined all the way down. And so right now I'm just clearing out the final bits of ores needed. And down below you can see, oh, that's interesting. It has a distance on that one. I put in a silver chest. I had a lot of silver and we've already done the wood. So I thought it'd be kind of, and we've done the diamonds as well. So I thought it'd be fun to use a different material because I was a little bit low on diamonds. So I thought, hey, silver's cool, man. And this is a 20 by 20 and it's already pretty full of stuff, which is great. So we've already picked up quite a few resources to kind of kick off the build that we're gonna do here. This area is gonna be kind of like the central computer. This is gonna be this really, I don't know how it's gonna be really detailed. Let's just put it that way. It's gonna be a really detailed build, but it's gonna have pretty much a singular purpose, and that is to store stuff. Now this here, I don't know how many items it's gonna store. I'm hoping it's gonna be enough. We can expand it up to 20 by 20, I believe is the default configuration that came with FOOLCRAFT. So that's double the size, but I'm gonna try this one for now. This chest is actually twice the size of any one I've ever used before. So hopefully, well, we'll see. We'll see what happens. Hopefully it's enough storage. I don't want to use the disk drives, even though we have a huge supply of the 1K storage, which is the foundational unit for making the disk drives in refined storage, which is, if you didn't know, was an AE2 Applied Energistics kind of replacement mod. It is a fantastic pack, and that's what we're basically going to be doing in the next couple episodes, is we're going to be setting up our permanent storage system that we're going to be able to use anywhere in the world. So this is going to be our central database. This is going to be the center, the nerve center of our entire series, now that we found a suitable location and we've kind of got a bit of a good build going. So I don't know if I need to set up anything else like Ender IO. It's possible that we might do that. I don't know for sure. I don't think I need anything from Ender IO except for possibly some of the item conduits and potentially some of the energy conduits. That being said though, I think the way refined storage works is I think we're using some of its like remote storage sensor stuff and some other doohickeys, we might be able to avoid that entirely. So yeah, I don't know yet. We're gonna see. But I really, really want to build this amazing tower out of basalt that's gonna rise from this very structured, very perfect hole, and it's gonna rise up through here and all the way above. And at the bottom, we're gonna probably put the Iskallium reactor. We're gonna make a massive one that goes down here. So it'll be the storage, then the Iskallium reactor, and then something else. I'm not entirely sure what is gonna be at the top, but I think that's where we'll put the actual computer brain. And that's a really, really cool block that glows and animates. And if you haven't seen it, just hold on, you'll see it possibly in this episode, maybe it'll be in the next episode. And it's gonna look fantastic. We're gonna do something really nice with that. We'll also use the ice blocks and the chiseled ice blocks around us because there's gonna be some pretty amazing block palettes I think we can come up with, and along with some snow, because the snow is naturally here all the way down to the bottom. bottom, so you can see how the snow is collecting, which I think is neat. Anyways, let me just finish doing some of this last little bit of grindy work. I'm going to clean up the walls here where I missed a few things, and we will be back shortly. All right, welcome back. Finished out all the little projects we needed up here. Dug out this hole here to make it look nice and pretty. This is the block palette I want to use. This is the cobalt, sorry, not the cobalt, the basalt blocks, and I've chiseled them out into the patterns I like. So we're going to get down there. We're going to work on that in a bit. But before we do that, I've been slowly crafting up some of these Iskallium steel reactor blocks. And basically, you just have to toss some steel in there. Like a so. I don't know what the minimum number is. Looks like we're out. I think I have some more in here. Let's grab two stacks of steel. Thank goodness for loot bags. Okay. Is that good? I got 64. I was like, I'm running out of scallion. I know I had stacking a bit from mining, plus not from mining, but a stack or like 48 from mining. I think we got the rest in loot bags or something like that. It was pretty good. Okay, so 36, I don't know. Let's start with that. I think this will make a small reactor. It's pretty rare though, man. I mean, if it wasn't for the loot farm we have, I don't know that it'd be that easy to make. Okay, so that's gonna require one for the controller. So this works like big reactors if you've never done it before. And I need a redstone. I need one redstone. Oh, please tell me I got a redstone up here. It's probably gonna be faster for me just to fly down and get it from here. So let's grab it out of the chest. Come on, give it to me. And we'll just grab some of the redstone. Perfect. Let's go. I think I got that. I hope I got it. Well, we'll find out pretty quick here. Although it's pretty hard to see. And not that we're actually going to ever access it. That's the other thing too as well. Okay, so let's make the power tap. Okay, so we just need one of those. So these are the basic things we need. Also, we need glass. Oh, gosh. If I don't have glass... that was an interesting chance cube. I was collecting some sand and it spawned in an army of these Enderman guys. Not that I really need to kill them, but okay, let's hit him in the head. Where'd you go? Okay, so the recipe for glass is pretty easy. It's actually, it's not bad. You get 9 for this. So you can put 9, you put 8 glass in, you get 9 back, which is kind of weird. You should probably get 8 back, but, that's okay. So we got that. Actually, I'm cooking up some glass right now because we'll make some we'll make some of the extra utilities glass that has sand glass or whatever the material is you need to combine. So that's nice to have because I really like it. So I think 9 glass is plenty to get this all sorted. So let's get down there. But before we do that, actually, I forgot. We need the most important part of the puzzle, which is we actually need to make ourselves some Iskallium. So let's go ahead and make 3. We'll leave those there for now. And let's go down here and lay out a pattern. I'm still a little nervous that this isn't right. Okay, let's let it open all the way. Oh yeah, it looks good. It looks good. All right. So for the center, I gotta get this out of my bag here. My bag here, please. My bag, thank you. Let's grab a few of these textures. Let's clean this up a little bit. Let's put some of the sand away. So I want to grab the panel. We're going to try out some different textures. The dent. And that's raw. Well, actually, we should grab some raw as well. That'll look good. And we got big tile, which might be good. And what else do we have? Encased bricks. Twisted. Okay, so this one I like a lot. I was thinking of using this one here. So I don't know if we just kind of go like this. It kind of has like a grill look to it, which I really like. So let's go ahead and we'll make a pattern. Okay, I like that. That was a happy accident. Unfortunately, that's going to go bye-bye into my chest of things. Let's see here. So let's go ahead and add in, is it 2, 2, 1, and then like so. I guess I can fly. I keep forgetting I can fly. I don't need to hover on the edge of my seat there. Okay, that looks good. I like that. Now we need another trim material. So we could do something like this. This one's the one I've wanted. This is the block I was hoping for. Right, because it all connects. The other one doesn't connect. The other panel doesn't do that. This one I like. See, and then if I go like this, it's yeah. This is a good block. This is one of my favorite blocks, actually, because it creates a nice little trim border. Okay, this is good. This is good. So we'll fill in this area like that. I guess we'll just go and fill the whole thing in. Because it's going to be covered, it doesn't really matter what's underneath. And this actually works out like a really good, solid border. Okay, that's cool, man. I like that. It's very simple, but it's got some detail. It's not high-tech looking, but it's future tech looking. I don't know what I'm saying. Okay, so right now, this is a problem because we have an even setup here, not an odd setup. The center is going to be like this. So we have to lay out the steel blocks like so. Unfortunately, I need a center one. So that means our Iskallium reactor actually has to be a lot bigger than I thought it was going to need to be. So this is going to kind of be the minimum size. And then we can come up like that and like that. And I don't even know if we need to go that tall, to be perfectly honest. I think we can go smaller. I think we can just go like this. I hope this is valid. Yes. Okay. I think that's good. We only have two blocks left, though. I might have to make some more of these casings. But that's okay. That actually is... it's not bad. It's not bad. Okay, the next thing we have to do is put in the controller. And let's see. That is the front of our thing. I guess I'll just put it at the back. It doesn't really matter. Apparently, there's supposed to be an interface for this thing. There's no interface yet. That's the power tap. That's how we get the power out. And then we need some Iskallium. And I can make more, which is good. So that's not a problem. We'll put in three... and it glows nicely, which is cool. This is a very squat reactor, but that's okay. I think this is valid. I'm pretty sure this is a valid reactor once we get that plugged in. Yeah, because you can have air blocks inside. That's not a problem. Okay, that's good. I don't know how to test it, though. We're going to have to make like a really simple RF device. So let me go get that steel and let me make an RF machine that we can test this out, and I'll be right back. I think I'm just going to test it out with the simple refined storage. I was looking at the recipe here for the controller. It's really simple. Diamond, electrical, or quartz enriched iron, which we got a lot of from our loot thing. I've got some quartz in here, and we're making some silicon. Hopefully that works. So we needed three silicon, a diamond, and I got... I think I have diamonds in here, actually. I might have taken them out. It's possible. Nope, there's one right there. Hi. Give me that, please. Okay, so I think we have everything, and the machine frame is just this quartz-enriched iron, which we had. Okay, so six of those. Actually, let's put the sand back in there, and we'll cook that up. So let's try to make this controller. Missing the machine frame. Yeah, let's make that. Okay, and I should have enough to go ahead and make this. Okay, that's super simple. That is a very light recipe. Also made the rest of the Iskallium reactor stuff, so we can go ahead and finish this. I actually was going to expand it. I had enough to... okay, do I not? Oh, I have my other pick. Let's go and do this so I can get this back. What? What happened there? Uh-oh. That's bad. Oh, gosh. Scared the bejeebers out of me. Holy moly. I was trying to use the other pick, but whatever. This is... oh, these break really easy. That's why. Oh, man. That's nuts. It's, like, super fast. Okay, anyways, let's... I think I have two more, right? Okay, good. And one, two. And then what I was thinking of doing is coming in here and... ooh, careful. Don't break the glass. I think we have enough. Yeah, I made enough glass to make a big reactor. Because you get 9 per thing, it's really easy to get the glass. And then I think I made enough casings now. So we at least have a cube as opposed to just some ugly... oh, wait, this is going to be incorrect here. This has to come out, which is fine. And we have to put some glass in here, which is good because it makes it look pretty. I like that. Okay. I do like the design of this. I'm a very big fan of green and gray. It's one of my favorite colors. I think we have to do that. I'm pretty sure. Okay. So let's grab the controller and confirm that this is getting power. We should just be able to attach it to the back of this thing like that. And it should light up. Oh, yeah. All right. So we have a valid reactor. Now, I don't remember how much it is per tick. I want to say it was 240 RF per block. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's going to be 1,200 and another 240. So 1,440-ish RF per tick. Forever passive, it never runs out of energy. So that's kind of what we want for our central hub. I never want to have to worry about fueling it up, so that's really good. So now if we look at the refined storage mod, essentially what we need to do is I don't want this brain to be here, so we need a couple things. We need to get energy up there, so that means we probably should. And I don't know how big of an Iskallium reactor we really need. It depends how much stuff we do. If we do a lot of energy, then we're going to want to get these really nice cables, which I think I can make. We're going to want these ones here, the 20,000 RF per tick. So basically, we need some binder, and the binder is just this junk, which we can make pretty easily. I even might have some clay. So I'm going to go craft those up. So I have a stack. I brought a stack of vibrant alloy. Hopefully that's enough. I mean, three, yeah, we'll probably have enough to run the cable. And then we'll run the cable from here all the way up to our final destination, where we'll build everything around this one controller. And then the last thing we need to make is we need to make an exporter. That's going to be an exporter, not exporter, sorry, external storage. So that means we got to get into these things. I have this part, but I don't have the solderer. And I don't have these printed things. So we're going to have to go make a bunch of stuff. And I'm going to kind of temporarily set it up over here. Or actually, yeah, we'll figure out. We might have to set it up upstairs. So I'm going to make that stuff. And I'll see you up top. Okay, so if we look straight up. No, I should just build up. Why build down when you can build up? Okay, so that's coming off the power tap. And I think we're good to just run it all the way up. I like the look of cables. I know you can do all kinds of stuff with transceivers and dimensional things. I don't have that stuff yet. We haven't built our Ender IO thing. So, okay, come on, Crash. Get up here. So, yeah, we'll get to it. We will. Don't worry. But for now, we're just going to use the simplest. I mean, at least I'm planning ahead by using the best cable. I just like the cables and the way they look because they're gonna be part of like a central kind of column. And it's all going to make sense when we get to the top. I think I got that to the right spot. Holy moly. Look at that. Oh, there's a lot of run. Ugh. Yeah, okay. I actually went one too far. So I would have had it wrong had I done it this way. So good thing I planned it correctly. Now I don't know what the final design up there is going to be. So we'll go ahead and we're just going to place it, put it in place for now. And then we can go from there. And once we decide, because you can, I think if it's like the old AE2 system or the new one, you can make a really cool super computer brain flashy thing at the top. It can be multiple blocks. I don't know if it's a multi-block anymore or not, but whatever. If it is, then we can make a big cube of sorts. All right. So that being said, let's go ahead and place in this controller, which is all charged, apparently. I guess it goes in charged. All right, sweet. Okay, so that's going to be, yeah, so if you think of it, this would be a block of four, right? So that's fine. Let's just break this around here. We can make four of these units and it would look cool. I don't know. I'll test that out and see if that's going to work. The next thing I need to do is actually, I need to pull the items down. And so we'll probably, what makes the most sense, because the Iskallium reactor is right in the middle. Ouchimama. I've left these holes here for this purpose. And what I'm probably going to do is run it through here. So let's go ahead and break this block. Yeah, so that should connect to this piece here. Now, okay, let's just, come on now. Do it properly. Can I do it? There we go. Okay, so now I've got that in place. That's going to get replaced with the external storage. Oh, I hate this part. And we'll just pull this pipe all the way up. Again, I like the pipe look. We'll do some kind of cool scaffolding or something. Can I pull this up all the way, please? Yeah, and you can use a network transceiver and all that stuff, like I said. But I don't want to use that because, well, first of all, I don't have the stuff to make it. Let's just start with that. But again, I like the piping. Have I said that 5 times yet? Have I said that enough times? I love the piping. And this stuff's really cheap to make. Super cheap, in fact. So, for now, This is what we're going to do. Okay, let me finish this off, and I'll see you in a few minutes once we get those other pieces cooked up. Okay, good. Let's go make it. Let's not fail on our jump. Let's go all the way to the top. And once we have this, then we can access the grid. We can connect the external storage, and we should be able to see if everything is groovy. Okay, so we've got that. So I think it's this, a grid, and one of these bad boys. Is that a recipe? It is. Okay, fantastic. Okay, while it's doing that, we're going to jump off the edge, and we're going to try not to kill ourselves, and we're going to land down here, and then we're going to go up here, and we're going to step onto this chest. This snow should go away, by the way. This is good. And then we are going to grab that external storage system. And this is just to replace the hard drive, because I don't think we need it. And okay, can I shift click this? Oh, I can. Okay, good. All right, so that's good. That is done now. Now I gotta go all the way back to the top. I think we will benefit from maybe a waystone here. Or we could use the Ender IO teleporters, but I think the waystones might be better. Might be more in line with the kind of the lore. Although the teleporters don't use any energy either. So external storage is connected. Solar is connected. Crafting grid. If I place this down right here. Oh, baby. Ooh, take that. Fantastic. Now, I have no idea how much space I have. Does it tell you somewhere? I thought it did, but... whew. That is the thing. That is the bomb. I mean, we have so much space now. It's incredible. So, and we have a crafting grid so we can craft stuff. It's in the worst possible spot, but I don't care. That is a major upgrade. Now, okay, so one of the things I did get is... where did I grab those? Okay, I've got some controllers. I got some dumb controllers. I want to try this out. I don't think this is a thing. No. No. That is too bad. I think I remember reading that it doesn't work that way. You can only have one controller. Oh, well. Oh, crap. Which is too bad. It really is too bad. Let's break this. We don't need this anymore. Because I was hoping... oh, well. I was hoping I could make it look pretty, but I'm not going to be able to do that. And now I have no fear. Guess what? I have no fear. Oh, careful. I don't have any fear of doing this because it just goes into the system and it sits there, which is fantastic. So I don't know how we can do... now I'm really, really not liking the odd or the even numbers because that's going to be a real problem. But oh well, we'll figure it out. All right, let me do a little bit of work and I'll be back with you guys in just a moment. Okie dokie, I was just coming down here to grab some of this glass because... oh, how'd you get in there? because I... wait, where's my sand? I think I can make the rest of this stuff now. Let's grab this. And if I remember correctly, if we take this and this... no, what is it? Do we have to... I can't remember. What was it? Glass. Let's just go glass. This one right here. Thickened glass. Sandy glass. Oh, it's 4x4. That's why. Sorry. Duh. Okay, so if we grab this and this. And I'm short one freaking piece. So funny. So we got the sandy glass. Which we then cook up into clear glass or whatever it is, right? It's this, and then it becomes thickened glass. And then we combine it into the other glass. And we end up with a nice glass texture, which I want to use a little bit here. I've gone ahead and built this platform. Right now, I'm just playing with ideas. I know it's a box. It's going to end up not being a box. It'll be kind of rectangular and circular at the same time. So it'll be wider than deep. And I think it's... going to be as, let's see here, I think it's going to be as deep as it's going to be this way, and then it's going to probably come out to about here, and then it's going to curve down. So we're going to make a big kind of dome thing on top here, and then all the way down, and then we'll do some cool intricate patterns all the way into the ground. I have an image. It's actually a building in San Francisco, the Marriott, that has this kind of really cool shape to it that I'm taking inspiration from. But anyways, guys, I think we are like super way over time. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I'm really excited to have the start of our central storage, which is super important for the rest of this build. Now we can build a lot of automation and stuff right here. We'll chunk load it so it's always operational, and then it'll be like our little certain like basic factory for the rest of our builds, because as you saw with the slime farm, we're overloaded and I really want to get all that loot into one central place so I have access to it at any time. Anyways, guys, that's it. If you like this video, make sure you bang on the like button down below, crash that subscribe button, and as always, I'd love to hear from you in the comments down below. My name is Crash, and I'm out.